Good afternoon. I'm Foresta Winthorpe. I am the head sniffer here at Sniffing Pinecones.
And I am Chief Sniffer, Timberland Hogwealth. Today we have a cornucopia of pinecones from around the globe. This is the first one from Indonesia. Perhaps a whiff of dark chocolate. It's not overly complex or overwhelming. You gotta smell this one.
Now we're going to try this one. This cone comes straight from Japan. It is imported. Now I must smell. It's like a mix of lilac and lavender. It's to die for. You simply must smell this.
Ah. Excellent. And this one is very special to us. It was overnighted to our studios from the rainforest of Orangapuntang. It's pleasant. It's a little fishy.
Fishy, with a hint of tart berry. Very odd.
Your regularly scheduled program, Sniffing Pinecones, will be missed tonight, so that we may bring you
Nintendo Junkie Tuesdays.
A little bit of bad news. The spot that I usually go to get NES games now only has games that I already own. So that's what I get for buying them all, I guess. But I went the other day and I got four games. I got Super R-Type for the Super Nintendo. I got Thunderbirds. And to be like Norji Tut, I got Super Mario Bros. Duck Hunt and World Class Track Meet 3-in-1. Now this game usually everywhere I go is about $15. And a lady that works there knows me really well, so I always go there, and she gave it to me for $5, so that was pretty cool. And here's a game on the rarity scale is a number 6 out of 10, and it's called Hattress. Not Tetris, but Hattress. So that's pretty cool. Gotta play that. Also, I got a lot recently off eBay. I needed to replace my top loader that I took apart, so I got one. This is my NES 2, number 2. This thing is built like a tank. These things will never break. It also came with the instruction manual for the system itself. That's pretty cool. It also came with the Castlevania 3 Dracula's Curse manual. Smash TV. Which is funny because those games aren't included, but there's three cases, which I don't even like these really, but I just have them. Here's what it came with. A lot on eBay. Mario 3. Not like I need another copy of that. Excitebike. This is new to me. Gyrus. I think I used to own this, and I thought I had it, but I didn't. Now I do, so that's good. Mario 2. Tetris 2. This game right here. Bomberman. This is the game that I thought was Mighty Bomb Jack, and I played it, and I was like, this isn't the same game. Bomberman. This is a cool game. The Little Mermaid. Another copy of Super Mario Bros. Duck Hunt. I think this is number 7 for me. And Tetris. So, very cool, very cool. Also, it came with another gun. Came with two sets of hookups. I don't know why it came with two sets, but it did. So, it's always cool to have backup. It came with 6 controllers. Let's see. There are 3 regular NES controllers and 3 of the dog bone controllers. I thought now would be a good time to go ahead and hang up the rest of the controllers onto the wall that aren't already there. I had them in rows on the wall, being very OCD, but I need more space now, so I'm just going to put them everywhere. Get crazy with it.
This is what my wall currently looks like. Time to go ahead and organize all my controllers. Alright, here's the completed wall. I actually ran out of hooks, so I have more controllers than hooks. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. But, pretty crazy. Look. Look, didn't even make a dent.
Nintendo has officially announced the release of the Nintendo DS 3D, and I haven't been able to find too much online about it, mainly because I haven't looked. But I do know that the red and blue glasses that everyone knows so well, what that does is it blocks out part of the image from each eye, and that's what gives it that 3D effect. And they found out a way to do that without the glasses, so it's going to look something like this. Alright, time for a little quickie poo. The winner from last week was Super Pitfall, so here's some footage for ya. Super Pitfall, this game is near impossible without cheats or codes. Let's give it a try. You start out as a little dude walking around, and every enemy will kill you in one hit. You do have a gun, it's kind of hard to aim. And it works? Oh, okay. And then here's some, you can swim in the water also. You don't fall, because if you do, you'll be falling forever. Or so it seems. You can also jump over spikes. Just be sure you don't miss, because if you do, you'll die. And you look weird when you die. Oh. You can get gold in this game, which is the most boring part of the game. Damn it! Alright, and I have five games to vote for this week for the Quickie Poo. We have Tetris. We have Tetris 2. We have Tetris Attack on the Super Nintendo. We have Hattris. Or we have Little Mermaid. Go ahead and vote now on the one you want to see next week.
Crazy Jim Heath, you've got the only one with a SpongeBob pillow.
Alright, thanks for watching. Happy 420, everybody, and we will see you next week.